Hi and welcome again. My name is Pizza Rashid. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work with foreach loop in C sharp. Before you start, I want you to open up this URL. Whatever code examples I use in this video are written step by step here. Code examples have a link to quickly taste it. And see the results in an online editor without writing a single word. I will also leave all the links at the end and in the description of this video. Let's get started. Foreach loop provides simple syntax to cycle through all the elements in the array or collection, unless you explicitly end the loop with the break command. This is the structure of a loop. Please pay attention. Foreach loop starts with the foreach keyword, followed by round brackets. Type is used to declare the data type of the variable. You can also use var keyword here, which instructs the compiler to infer the type of the item from the type of the collection. Item is the looping variable used inside the loop body, into which next element is automatically acquired from this collection on each iteration. You can name the item whatever you like, but the data type must match with the type of elements in the collection. That means if the elements in the collection are integer type, the type of item must be integer. Collection is the array or list with the values over which you want to iterate. And finally, this is the block of code that executes for each iteration of the loop multiple times. Let's see the execution order of a loop. This is the list or array of elements over which you want to iterate. Then the element is received from the collection one by one on each iteration. Now body executes. This repeats multiple times until all the elements in the collection are assigned. That means if there are three elements in the collection, loop will iterate three times. Let me quickly code a basic foreach loop, then I explain it to you. Well, I have declared and initialized this array, which is of int type, and assigned an initial value of 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then there is foreach loop. Here I have declared an int variable named value that is used for looping. Why I have used int type? This is because our array is of integer type, and each element in the array is integer value. Each time the loop runs, an element from this array is assigned to this variable. For example, the first time loop runs, the number 1 is assigned to value variable. It then executes the code within the body of foreach loop, where this statement simply prints out the number 1, which is the value of this variable. In the second iteration, the number 2 is assigned and printed out. This continues until all the elements in the array have been printed. This means that the code inside foreach loop is called as many times as there are elements in the integer values array. If this contains 4 elements, the code inside the loop block will execute 4 times. Click run. Here is the output. You can also use var keyword here, instead of explicit data type like this. Now the compiler determines and assigns the most appropriate data type to the value variable just by looking at the type of your array. Same output. If you have more than one statement, you must enclose the statements in opening and closing braces like this. Of course, you can use braces with the single statement as well. What if you want to terminate the loop when a certain condition meets? In this case, you need to use break statement, also called jump statement. Break keyword causes the loop to exit before it completes the iterations. This is done from the loop body during an iteration. The control is then passed to the first statement immediately following the loop. Let me add break statement. Click run. This loop writes out the numbers 1 and 2. But when value variable reaches 3, this condition evaluates to true because 3 is equal to 3. Then the break keyword causes the loop to exit and it resumes from here, immediately after the loop. Skip the value 3 and 4. Another jump statement that is commonly used is the continue statement. With the use of continue statement, the rest of the current iteration is skipped after continue keyword and immediately initiates the execution of the next iteration. In other words, loop starts over again. Let me change break to continue statement first. Click run. When the value variable reaches 3, then this condition evaluates to true. The continue keyword then causes the loop to skip rest of the current iteration and initiates the execution of the next iteration. All the numbers will be printed out except one, which is 3. This is due to the continue statement because it skipped rest of the loop body.